We would like to acknowledge that Mount Allison University is located within the traditional territory of Mi'kmaq, the unceded ancestral homelands of Mi'kmaq. Our relationship and privilege to live on this territory was agreed upon in the Peace and Friendship Treaties of 1725 to 1752. Because of this treaty, relationship is to be acknowledged that we are all treaty people and have a responsibility to respect this territory.
Good afternoon and congratulations to you, the classes of 2020 and 2021. You have returned from many places across New Brunswick, Canada, and even the world to return to this great Convocation Hall. It is indeed a special time. The Buddhist teacher, Thich Nhat Hanh, said, "Every breath we take, every step we make, can be filled with peace, joy, and serenity. We need only to be awake, alive in the present moment." This is indeed a great moment to be awake. We gather to this to celebrate the accomplishments of you, the graduates, to give thanks for the friendships formed, the memories created, the knowledge learned, and even to recall the struggles that built resilience. It is a time to pause and acknowledge the many people that have supported you during your time here and the way this university has shaped you as human beings. So as we gather in this place, may we indeed be filled with joy, peace, serenity, and gratitude.
Few moments of good advice before you begin on the Mount Allison. experience after a little time has passed. C'est un moment à réfléchir à cette expérience universitaire que vous avez. You have now had a year or two to take what you learned from your experiences here on day to test them in other places and settings. Now some of you have gone on to graduate school opportunities where you have the benefit of seeing different approaches to teaching and learning at other institutions. Some of you have had your first corporate jobs and are drawing upon that experience as a student to learn about your position. Some of you, of course, are still deciding what your next step will be, a process that you will carry on throughout your lives and determine what the next best stages. If we then work well, then I will be happy or not. For the rest of your life, no matter where you are or what you are doing, there will be things that you know because you learn them and not ask them. Or new things that you're not afraid to try because you learn the value of doing so here. Or completely unknown things that do not intimidate you because you remember what it was like navigating new and unfamiliar territory. If we ever work well, and I hope we have, then your time here will continue to inform and support you throughout your life. You graduated at an obviously very challenging time. Your opportunities to expect the time you arrived here in the first year may not be available now. Some may no longer exist. But there are new opportunities, new possibilities that you never imagined. Now, while the pandemic changed things a little, more quickly and a little more dramatically than usual, changing work and opportunities is a constant in every generation. New ideas, new technology, new priorities not only change how work is done, but what work is done. Change, however, can be unsettling. It creates uncertainty, and most of us prefer to know but what is coming your way is change. Change isn't uncertainty. If you can learn to view it not as something to be feared, but as something to be embraced, then change will absolutely energize you. Change certainly keeps life interesting. Your undergraduate degree in LA has already given you the tools that you need to meet change. After all, the most important thing we've learned here about today is how to learn. And you're going to keep on learning and growing and changing for the rest of your lives. I encourage you to find new ways to make that happen. Actively seek out learning opportunities. Find new experiences. Challenge yourself to try something new, something unfamiliar. Find new mentors. One only has to look at our honorary degree recipients today, seeing that there are incredible people across this country from whom you can learn. Probably at the moment, I think personally, I'm going to get to the adult. So we are now with the individuals and I get to the general effect of that. Most importantly, be the curator of your own life. Don't let someone else shape or tell your story. There will be external things that will happen, like the pandemic, that you have no control over. But you get to decide those things that will impact your lifelong journey. Don't let someone else choose your path or your story. Write down your own narrative and curate it. That's especially true in today's omnipresent social media. The further you move away from your experience here in LA, the more likely you will see how it has impacted you. I often get the chance to meet alumni graduates of my university in my role as president, and it's always incredibly compelling to hear them speak about their time at LA and how it would affect them and the relationships that they build throughout their lifetime. It's also fascinating to hear more about the many ways in which they are influencing communities in which they live. Few of them are making headlines. Few are also on anyone that you'd be proud to tell in 10, 15, 20, or 50 years from now. Retourne sicure à la race. Retourne ici à sa cure. Répondez votre histoire. Répondez votre aventure. We'll be waiting to hear it.
Chancellor, platform guests, member of faculty and staff, graduates of the classes of 2020 and 2021, families and friends. It is a great delight for me to present Scott McCain. Scott McCain has held senior leadership roles in some of Canada's most iconic organizations, Maple Leaf Foods and McCain's Foods Limited, where he is the chair of the board. He is currently the president and COO of JSM Capital Corporation, a private investment holding company. McCain has shown his passion for sports and Mount Allison by supporting the Alumni Field Project, numerous athletic scholarships, and the volleyball, hockey, and basketball teams. His support is rooted in his experience that athletics provides a great venue for personal growth, achievement, and making lifelong friendships. He is a member of the Fifth Quarter Club, vice president of the class of 1978, and served as a member of the Board of Regents for 15 years. As co-chair of the Mount Allison Jump campaign, he helped raise more than $96 million for the university. McCain is also involved with the Ron Joyce Center for Business Studies, hosting commerce students during their annual trip to Toronto, and he has sat on the Ron Joyce Advisory Board for many years. He is a director of Seafort Capital Incorporated and of the Margaret and Wallace McCain Family Foundation Incorporated. He is currently the chief executive officer of the St. John Major Junior Hockey Club Limited and owner of the St. John Sea Dogs of the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League. Proud of his New Brunswick roots, McCain is a champion and promoter for the Maritime region. A Mount Allison Commerce graduate, McCain is well known for his exemplary contributions in business, community service, post-secondary education, and for his volunteerism and philanthropy. Ms. Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of Mount Allison University, I request that you confer upon Scott McCain the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
Scott McCain, on behalf of the Senate of Mount Allison University, we are pleased to confer on you the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. The hood with which we are investing you and the diploma we are presenting to you are the outward symbols of your membership in this venerable and distinguished community. We are honored to have you as a Mount Allison graduate and look forward to your continued association with the university.
Ms. Chancellor, platform guests, members of the faculty and staff, graduates of the class of 2020 and 2021, family and friends, I am honored to present Beth Pounding. Beth Pounding is an award-winning author and an accomplished photographer. She has also written numerous articles and essays that have been included in publications like Chatelaine, the Toronto Star, Canadian Home and Country, and Harrowsmith. She is the author of four novels: The Sister's Tale, A Measure of Light, The Sea Captain's Wife, and The Hatbox Letters, as well as three works of literary nonfiction: Edge Seasons, Shadow Child, and Home, Chronicle of a North Country Life. Her works have been published in both Canada and the US. She has won the New Brunswick Award for Literary Fiction and has been shortlisted for the Thomas Riddell Book Award, the Wordsworthy Award, and the Edna Stabler Award. Her books have been on the Globe and Mail and Maclean's bestsellers lists, as well as earning Globe and Mail best book titles. She is a devoted volunteer, sharing her time and gifts with many community organizations, including the Sussex Regional Library, the Sussex Choral Society, and the 2026 Advisory Council to the Premier. She lives in rural New Brunswick with her husband, Arthur Peter Pounding, where they grow most of their own food in extensive vegetable gardens. I'll be visiting later this summer. Ms. Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of Mount Allison University, I request that you confer upon Beth Pounding the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
Beth Pounding, on behalf of the Senate of Mount Allison University, we are pleased to confer on you the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. The hood with which we are investing you and the diploma we are presenting to you are the outward symbols of your membership in this venerable and distinguished community. We are honored to have you as a Mount Allison graduate, and we look forward to your continued association with the university. Ms. Chancellor, platform guests, members of the faculty and staff, graduates of the classes of 2020 and 2021, families and friends, I am honored to present the Honorable Dominic A. LeBlanc. First elected in 2000 and re-elected 7 times since, the Honorable Dominic LeBlanc is the past president of the Queen's Privy Council for Canada and Minister of Intergovernmental Affairs, Infrastructure and Communities. He served as the chair of the Cabinet Committee on the federal response to the coronavirus disease. He has represented the riding of Beauséjour for more than 20 years and has served as Minister of Intergovernmental and Northern Affairs and Internal Trade, Minister of Fisheries, Oceans and the Canadian Coast Guard, and Leader of the Government in the House of Commons. He previously served as Deputy Government Whip and Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of National Defense. Minister LeBlanc attended the University of New Brunswick, the University of Toronto, Trinity College, and Harvard Law School. Prior to holding elective office, Minister LeBlanc was a senior advisor to the former Prime Minister of Canada, Jean Chrétien, and a lawyer with Clark Drummy in Shediac and Moncton, New Brunswick. Minister LeBlanc is married to Jolene Richard, the former Chief Judge of the New Brunswick Provincial Court. Ms. Chancellor, on behalf of the Senate of Mount Allison, I request that you confer upon the Honorable Dominic A. LeBlanc the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa.
Dominic LeBlanc, on behalf of the Senate of Mount Allison University, we are pleased to confer on you the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. The hood with which we are investing you and the diploma we are presenting to you are the outward symbols of your membership in this venerable and distinguished community. We are honored to have you as a Mount Allison graduate and look forward to your continued association with the university.
Your Honor, Madam Chancellor, Dr. Boudreau, Mr. Cooper, members of the faculty, special guests, graduates, and students, thank you for asking me to join you today, and thank you for this flattering introduction. Jolene and I are very honored to be here with you today and to share this momentous occasion with all of you. I am also deeply proud to share this stage with my fellow honorary doctorate recipients. Your contributions to Canada have been enormous, and I am humbled to be in your company as well. Mr. Cooper, thank you for your kind words. We have been friends for over 40 years, and your presence here makes this moment also very special for me. We all know that Mount Allison University has a stellar reputation, a global reputation. And I worry that by bestowing this honor upon me today, that reputation may be taking a hit. And graduates, I fear the value of your degree may be somewhat diminished. But I see that Scott McCain is here today. And Scott, I very much hope you won't have to pay Maclean's magazine next year to maintain the ranking of Mount Allison University. But joking aside, I am very moved to be here, as this is the first time I have experienced anything like this. This is a very significant honor, and I am humbled by your gesture. There were many thoughts that ran through my head when I received that phone call from Dr. Jean-Paul Boudreau last spring. First and foremost, I wish that my father could be here today, as it was 45 years ago this month that he stood on this very stage and received his own honorary degree from Mount Allison. I was 9 years old, and I remember my dad was filled with excitement, which, to be honest, I did not totally understand, because of course I felt like I was being dragged once again to yet another event. And I imagine that some of you can also feel that today, attending a convocation ceremony, because your parents wanted to be here as well. But it was not just another event, and now I look back on that day in 1977 as a tremendously proud son. The world has changed in many ways since then. At that time, my father was Canada's Minister of the Environment, and we were grappling with what was described as the worst environmental problem Canada has ever had to face, acid rain, which put at risk thousands of freshwater lakes and rivers and required international political action. Canada has indeed made tremendous progress in many areas since those days. But today, our country is faced with many complex challenges as well. In many ways, Canada is at a crossroads. Democracies are more fragile than previously thought possible. A few short years ago, few would have believed that individuals would storm the United States Capitol, or that Canada would witness a convoy of trucks taking over the streets in front of Parliament Hill. We also did not expect that a few short months ago, a war would be started in Ukraine and threaten decades-old peace and international rules-based order in Europe. We each have a responsibility to not turn a blind eye to these events. As a country, Canada is still very young. We must work to advance reconciliation and address colonial legacies. It is not easy for us to comprehend this dark period of our history. We must collectively address systemic racism and discrimination towards all people and ensure that our prosperity and promise is shared with the greatest number of people. Que ce soit en comblant les écarts en matière d'infrastructure, en finançant par exemple des services de garde adaptés aux réalités culturelles des peuples autochtones ou en répondant aux appels à l'action de la Commission de vérité et réconciliation du Canada, nous avons un devoir collectif à réparer ces torts historiques. Nous devons parcourir ce chemin pour guérir ensemble. Countless countries around the world are working together to tackle climate change, but more clearly needs to be done. It is through our collective efforts that we can make communities more resilient, move to net zero, and mitigate the impacts of climate change that we are all seeing too frequently day in day. I watch in awe as young people take on the advocacy of protecting our environment and our planet, and I know that it is your generation that will lead the fight to save this planet. This existential threat needs all of us to step up, and your generation has been the first to do so. I know that when you started at Mount Allison, as Dr. Boudreau just said, you didn't expect life to be changed by a global pandemic. Yet you are all too familiar with the impact that this last 2 years has had on your fellow students, on your friends, and on your family members. It is well known in Canada that Mount Allison Student Union is a proud leader in strong mental wellness and mental health supports. Be proud of your student government's contribution to eliminating the stigma often associated with mental illness, and this inspiring advocacy by Mount Allison students began well before COVID. There is no question that COVID-19 has hit people hard, but if there is a positive, it is how Canadians have overwhelmingly stepped up and looked out for each other. In the same way, we're very confident that your generation will continue to look out for your fellow citizens when you leave Convocation Hall today. Today is not just another ceremony for you either. You are celebrating an important achievement that represents a lot of hard work and perseverance. I salute you and I commend you for your tenacity. Mount Allison, as I said, is built on a long tradition and a well-recognized tradition of academic excellence. Today, you become part of that. Your degree will provide you with many new challenges and opportunities. As the Danish philosopher Kierkegaard famously said, life can only be understood backwards, but it must be lived forwards. Yes, there will be elements of randomness and of chance in all our lives. But as the saying goes, luck comes to those who are prepared for it. More than anything, my father's generation was committed to public service, and I have been inspired by their love for Canada. But I think it's important to underscore that the foundation of Canada is largely based on the belief that people have in their country. Citizens want and need to be assured that they are contributing to national purpose and to the greater good. What should bring all of us together is the idea that we can work together to make our country fairer, more inclusive, and sustainable. Canada is not a place that should be taken for granted. Democracy is worth defending, and we all need to work hard to preserve the unique quality of life we all enjoy in this country. Yes, we're certainly not a perfect country, but if every day we strive to work together and make our country even a better place for all of us, then we will be moving Canada forward. And if we do this, we will remain a nation that other countries look to as a model of diversity and inclusion. There are many ways to serve one's country, and I encourage you to find your own way to contribute. Alors que vous entamez ce nouveau chapitre de votre vie, croyez en votre capacité d'être des leaders dans votre communauté et laissez votre voix être entendue. Vous avez un rôle important à jouer dans la protection et la promotion des valeurs qui unissent les gens, la compassion, la justice, l'égalité et l'inclusion. Souvenez-vous que le Canada est uni par les voix bien intentionnées et pas par celles qui sèment la division. If I can leave you with one thought, let it be this. Mount Allison has provided you with the tools to accomplish important things. Believe that you can make a difference in Canada and in the world. And please step up. Lean in. The country needs you. Live your lives forward. And at the end, your contribution to a better society will be the measure of that success. I wish all of you the best in the future. Congratulations, and thank you for including me in this tremendous honor. Merci beaucoup.
Preeminent Faculty Award at Mount Allison, the Paul Paré Medal, is awarded annually to a professor who has best demonstrated outstanding teaching, outstanding research, scholarship, and/or creative activities and an exemplary record of service. In 2020, the Paul Paré Medal was awarded to Dr. Stephen Runge, a professor in the Department of Music. In 2021, the Paul Paré Medal was awarded to Dr. Lauren Beck, a professor of Languages and Literatures and Visual and Material Culture Studies. Now I'd like to ask my colleague, Dr. Kevin Morse, from the Department of Music to please stand. Dr. Kevin Morse from Manalis's Department of Music was the recipient of the 2020 Herbert and Leota Tucker Teaching Award. The award is Mount Allison's highest recognition of teaching excellence. Dr. Morris has taught at Mount Allison since 2011, specializing in music composition, orchestration, and arranging. He also teaches opera history and music in Canada courses, which are open to students from a wide range of backgrounds, including non-music students. Many of Dr. Morris's courses focus on the practical skills of writing music and involve hands-on experiential learning as students turn their initial ideas into a written score and eventually into live performance or electronic composition. Discussion-based workshops or works in progress form a key part of many of Morse's classes. Student composers have their compositions performed in the New Music at Mount Allison concerts Morse organizes each semester, a series which he started in 2012. In 2019, he created a partnership for student composers to create new compositions for the music department's chamber ensembles to perform at the end of the semester. Dr. Morse also brings guest artists into his courses to inspire his students, recently including a film composer and an electronic music composer. Dr. Morse has also been active as a supervisor of summer student research. His students have gone on to some of the top graduate programs in Canada, have won composition awards, and have received Social Sciences and Humanities Research Council SHRC graduate scholarships. Established by Edmund Harold and William Tucker in memory of their parents, the Tucker Teaching Award is intended to encourage excellence in teaching at Mount Allison University by acknowledging those who exemplify it. And I can't think of anyone more deserving than Dr. Morse. Congratulations, Dr. Morse. Perhaps just as deserving, in 2021, the Herbert and Leota Tucker Teaching Award was awarded to Dr. Susie Andrews from the Department of Religious Studies. And while I have the mic, I'd like to take the opportunity to thank and show our appreciation for our tremendous faculty who I am privileged to work with on a daily basis and without whom none of us could be here and the students couldn't graduate. Thank you so much for your incredible work to the faculty and academic staff.
Honored Chancellor, it is my privilege to announce today the bestowing of the title of Emeritus Professor or Associate Professor, as the case might be, a title that is given to faculty members who were long serving at Mount Allison and have recently retired. Since our last convocation, those receiving Professor Emeritus status are Dr. Terrence Craig from the Department of English, Dr. Robert Ireland from Biology, and Professor Robert Adlam from Anthropology. Receiving the title of Associate Professor Emeritus is Gary Tucker from Music and Professor Judith Holton from the Department of Commerce and the Ron Joyce Center for Business Studies. I would also like to acknowledge the late Dr. David Torrance, who would have received this honor at a previous convocation, but unfortunately passed away before the honor could be bestowed. Thank you.
Madam Chancellor, today we recognize former chancellors, presidents, and directors for their contribution and service to Mount Allison. I ask that the audience hold their appreciation until all emeritus appointees have been recognized. I wish to acknowledge the following. This group will not be attending today, but we honor them. Chancellors Emeriti John Bragg and Peter Mansbridge, President Emeritus Robert Campbell, Chaplain Emeritus the Reverend John Perkin, and with us today, the Registrar Emerita, who will stand, Christine or Chris Parker.
Honoranda Cancellaria, he baccalauri, quos ante aduce ad gradum admissunt. Honored Chancellor, the following are those who have already graduated. First, from the class of 2020, with a Bachelor of Science with first class honors. Jana Arsenault. Brian David Beardsall. Bailey Starr Bowen. Emma Donnell Kruselbrink. Matthew LeBlanc Buckley. Sarah Caitlin McConnell. Rachel Marie McDougall. Stephanie Ann McKenna. Everett Avison Patterson. Michael Perry. Madeline Elizabeth Power. Madeline Dawn Russell. Kaylee August Riles. Jessica Louise Vickery. Natalie Renee Legacy. Allie Grace Rogerson. Emma Deanne Rogerson. And with a Bachelor of Science with Honors, Jasmine Marie Anderson. Allison Jane Clark. Emma Christine Farrell. Samuel Allen Fisher. Sarah Jane Rudder Gordon. Risha Davy Minocha McKenney. And with a Bachelor of Science, Colby Terrence Evans. Gregory Paul Bailey. Marco Bruno Boudreau. Samantha Lynn Crook. Shekhar Dewan. Sarah Jane Doak. Orissia Maria Peyton Ellis. Carolyn Hitchcock. Cole Nathan Delphus Jacquard. Michelle Ann James. Jocelyn Geraldine Mary Morton. Angelica Jade Oikel. Brady Ryan Parcells. Hannah Taylor Potts. Camden Douglas Sutherland. J. Jessica Dawn Smith. Mihar Rauf. Cody Alexander Rendell. Rachel Jeanette Richardson. William Albert Richards. Megan Elizabeth Sanderson. Taylor Michael Smith. Grace Marie Snowden. Sertara Alethea Wilkinson. Ariana Aniqua Woodley. Graduating with a Bachelor of Commerce with First Class Honors, Kelton Reese Welsh. Graduating with a Bachelor of Commerce, Alexandria Marlene Dolan. Sophia Gadet. Alex Patrick LeBlanc. Alexandre Justin Lynch. Beatrice Fernandez Pierce. Riley Ellis Robichaud. Brandon Alexander Smike. Kathleen Ann Squires. Nicholas Lawrence Steves. With a Bachelor of Arts with First Class Honors, Amira Hassan Aboulish. Kennedy Grace Longafee. Evan Christopher Paul Matthews. Luke Ryan Mungle. Liliana Rose Simmons. Nigel Laurier Meredith Verrett. Liam Matthew Power McInnes. With a Bachelor of Arts with Honors, Minaho Ahi. Mary Siobhan Doyle. Natalia Liste Colomina. Sean Andrew McNeil. Paige Caitlin Percy. Samuel Wilson Unger. With a Bachelor of Arts, Claudia Maria Ferrero Chanfrau. Loren Layton Francis Bedgood. Anna Marie Campbell. Maxwell John Chapman. Melody Ann Kobe. Burton Anthony Cormier. Molly Josephine Donahue. Gloria Ferra. Bradley Scott Gamble. Brooke Morgan Gillespie. Tristan Renee Haley. Noah Daniel LeBlanc. Matthew McKee Muir. Natasha Sybil Niles. Lika Chanel Cruz Pacheco. Madison Deborah Phillips. Amina Roderica Simmons. Brandon Alexander Steele. James Murray Thomas. With a Bachelor of Fine Arts, Sean Bernard Carey. Natalie Ann Rippey. With a Bachelor of Music, Brianton Wayne Innes. Joseph Edouard Weary Lafreniere. Samuel Alexander McCormick. Isaiah Marcus Yankich. Yeah. Wait a second. And now, from the class of 2021. Having achieved a Bachelor of Science with first class honors, Jenna Lori Chisholm. Lauren Michelle Desereaux. Allison Ann Marie McCormick. Leah Rennell Massers. Parik Ewan Otis. Alexi Jeannie Huillette. Maggie McCauley Pickard. Madeline Claire Robitaille. Sarah Lynn Sydney Zassman. With a Bachelor of Science with honors, Samuel Charles Harrison Chambray. Megan Marie Fitzgerald. Emily Marie Rhino. Natalie Jane Barnhill. Cassidy Anise Coombs. Andrew William James. Allison Jane McIntosh. Michael Anthony McEachern. Laura Catherine Rowan Legg. Bethany Hope Barrett. Lauren Emily Boyce. Zachary Daniel Brown. Mitchell James Catania. Leo Paul Lloyd Deon. Logan Roslyn Hamilton. Vasance Cannon. Shayna A. Kennedy. Shalini Shanti Ann Khanna. Alyssa Catherine Madonna Leonard. Jihao Li. Haley Anna McEachern. Lily Helen McLean. Sophia Narayani Patrick. Jonah John Pelkey. Nathan John Price. Emma Esther Lee Roberts. Braylon Marie Schultz. Robin Marie Simpson. Michaela White. Angelica Whiteway. Brandon Pineo. With a Bachelor of Commerce, Brock McEwen. Haley Karen Sullivan. Alex William Bishop. Madeline Elizabeth Byrne. Dominic Daniel Cormier. Julia Lyndon Hunter. Stephanie Marie Medeiros. Sonia Minocha. Blake Barrington Thompson. Having graduated in October of 2020 with a Bachelor of Science, Maya Lee Wade. Corrine Elise Hissey. Grace Roby. Matthew Keith Tanton. And now with a Bachelor of Arts with first class honors from 2021, Julia Ann Connolly. Michael Vincent Cormier. Juan Gabriel Facundo Fuentes. Jonathan Lang Ferguson. Maggie Carla Ivamy. Elizabeth Helen March. Caitlin Monique O'Connor. Amy Rebecca Ward. Libby Marie Morash. Morgan Dale Steves. Lauren Alyssa Stoddart. With a Bachelor of Arts with Honors, Emma Bailey Jacobson. Shannon Kelsey Dill. Sydney Jean Fougere. Sydney Elizabeth Thorburn. Jillian Marie Arsenal. Samuel Ryan Millette.
Yes, sir.
And with a Bachelor of Arts, Daniel Alexander Bell. Gabrielle Liliane Brochu. Sarah Zariah Acacia. Let me do that again. Sarah Zariah Acacia.
Zaria.
I'm sorry. Pardon? Zaria. It's Sarah Zariah Acacia. My apologies. Ryan Joy Belia. Brandon Byron Richard Blakeney. Kayla Hope Blanchard. Lauren Taylor Bourgeois. Catherine Gwen Campbell. Catherine Jane Campbell. Shaylin Elizabeth Carroll. Noemi Chasson. J.C. May Connors. Marcus Isaiah Darrell Johnson. Shaylin Marie Decare. Christy Lynn Earls. Rebecca Edith Estabrooks. Georgia Bryn Forsyth. Sandon Paul Gagnon. Kayla Dawn Haddad. Madeline Ann Grace Eisner Ryan. Nathan Tobias Jones. Anne Florence Keating. Paul John Keating. Megan Louise Langell. Claire Danielle Legier. Callie Elizabeth McDonald. Bethany Maria McKinnon. Luke Alistair McGowan. Joseph James McLaughlin. Luke Eric Murchison. Randy James O'Connor. Loli Pushpa Pagar. Alyssa Lori Jean Robinson. Lauren Ray Lynn Shea. Julia Supernaw Johnson. Emily Jane Taylor. Cassidy Lee Van Wart. Amy Millicent Walker. Shelby Elizabeth Wright. And with a Bachelor of Fine Arts, Megan Elizabeth Glauser. Elijah Samuel Hayes Marr. Emily Catherine Jean Shaw. With a Bachelor of Music, Gabrielle Liliane Rochu. Justin Rodney Reed. Gibson John McMillan. Brianna Lee Green. Shanae Jamie Noel Thiessen. Vasilika Vangeli. And with Commerce from 2020, Ivan Fernandez.
We're almost done. There was a lot of graduates. Very exciting. Ms. Chancellor, each year the graduating class chooses one graduate to represent the class and to deliver the valedictory address. This is, of course, a great honor, but also a great responsibility, as a valedictorian must find a way to adequately sum up 4 years of life-changing times at Mount Allison. Our valedictorians for the year 2020 and 21 have been waiting a long time to deliver their comments, and they're here. I'm gonna introduce them briefly. I'm gonna ask them to come up to the stage in a moment. We'll begin with the class of 2020, who is Nigel Verrett, to deliver the valedictory address. Nigel doubly represents the class of 2020, and he's also the grad class president. Nigel came to Mount Allison from Vancouver, British Columbia, and graduated with a major in economics and a minor in commerce and mathematics. Nigel is also the recipient of the Charlie Hunter Award, one of Mount Allison's top graduating awards. Following Mount Allison, Nigel headed to Queen's University to pursue a master's degree in economics. Madam Chancellor, it's my pleasure to present Nigel Verrett as the class of 2020 valedictorian. The class of 21 valedictorian is Angelica Whiteway. Angelica is from Black Rock, Nova Scotia, and graduated with a major in biology and a minor in political science. She is the recipient of a university leadership pin for her service. Angelica is currently working as a scientist in Nova Scotia, near and dear to her home and in a field that she is so passionate about. Madam Chancellor, it is my pleasure to present Angelica Whiteway as the class of 2021 valedictorian. Angelica and Nigel, please come to the podium.
Make us sound like Jedis. Like, great power comes great responsibility. Okay. Good afternoon, class of 2020.
And 2021.
Doesn't it feel good to be back? Let's hear it. You've probably heard me say this, or I feel like I've said this a lot over the weekend, but it is so, so nice to see you all. Scanning the crowd, however, at your beautiful, lovely, perhaps a little sunburnt faces, I think it's important to note that there are a handful of faces missing from this crowd.
While we are sadly not all able to make it here today, just being able to gather and celebrate has been unreal. If the last 2 years has taught us anything, it's to never take our time with our loved ones for granted, and instead to savor all the time we have in the physical presence of those that are closest to us. And here we are again, after 1 or 2 years, reunited at last.
Reunited to celebrate the completion of our degrees and all that means to us. From the highs to the lows and everything in between. Where am I? Thank you. We're here to recognize the work we put in, the personal growth we experienced, and the people we met along the way. People without whom completing a degree would have been much more difficult.
It's really hard to do a speech sweating in these. Yes. This occasion has certainly been a long time coming for us. Neither the classes of 2020 or 2021 got the endings we deserved. We spent some of our most formative years here, learning not only about academic matters, but about ourselves and our places in the world. All these core and meaningful life experiences culminated in a mere click of a button.
We quite literally hit send on our degrees. I decided to add that flair last minute. And carried on with our lives. Hardly the ending I had personally envisioned, sitting through Calc 2, dreaming about the moment this would all be over. Spent a lot of time doing that in that class. And yes, yet, I'd like to think that we have reasons to be grateful for the way this all turned out. The journeys of the classes of 2020 and 2021 are intrinsically linked. And it's fitting that we get the opportunity to graduate together today.
To many in the class of 2021, the class of 2020 were the ones who welcomed us into residence when we first arrived here on campus. They were also the volunteers at our orientation, they were our TAs, and the leaders of the clubs and societies that we joined. Most importantly, though, they were our friends. To see those from the class of 2020 again has been surreal, because we truly didn't get a goodbye when they left Sackville at the start of the pandemic.
On the flip side, to the class of 2020, many of the class of 2021 are those who started at Mount A in our second year, around the time we got tired of our friends from first year. They were those welcome, fresh faces to remind us of our wild first year days, which we could relive vicariously through them. They also provided us with many of our first experiences in positions of leadership, giving us lots of enthusiasm as members of the clubs and societies that we low-key pressured them into joining, and keeping things, shall we say, interesting as resident staff and executives.
Shout out to the Harper Hall toilet incident.
But more importantly, they were also our colleagues and friends. They were people we hung out with at the library, waited in line at Ducky's with, shared tables at Jennings with, and so much more.
We have shared so many spaces and experiences together as students at Mount Allison. So it feels particularly apt that we share this space here to honor this milestone we achieved together. I think it's fair to say that we would not have gotten here without each other.
We would like to take this chance to give a heartfelt thank you to Mount Allison faculty and staff, and to the town of Sackville for giving us a reason to be back here today. back among dear friends, mentors, and family. We would also like to congratulate the class of 2022, who will be crossing the stage themselves tomorrow. It has been such a treat seeing and catching up with everyone again this weekend. As we prepare to leave the Sackville bubble and get on with our lives, we would like to wish you all the best for what lies ahead.
Since leaving Mount Allison, I hope your experiences from your degree are carried with you on the path that you're on now. I hope you are still advocating for what is right and using your voices to speak against injustices in the world. I also hope that you had the time of your life at the best and most elaborate 1 and 2 year reunions ever. And we can't wait to come together again soon. Congratulations to the classes of 2020 and 2021.
Good afternoon, everybody. On behalf of the 23,000 Mount Allison alumni around the world, I'd like to offer our congratulations to the 2020 and 2021 graduates, and happy to see you all at your in-person convocation celebration. When I was writing this speech late last night, but that's not important right now, I was struggling with tense. How do I welcome you to something that happened a year and a half ago, or 2 years ago, or 1 year ago, and wish you success on things you've already completed? So I don't think there's a past, future, perfect tense. I didn't study English here to know what to say, so just bear with me. Welcome to the lifelong community of Mount Allison alumni. I hope that the magic, the special sauce that is the Mount A experience never truly fades, and I hope, despite the last couple of years, you all have treasured your time here. So as you leave Sackville, please know that the university alumni are interested in where you go from here. Getting master's or PhDs, entering the work world, becoming educators or civil servants, entrepreneurs or business leaders, artists, poets, musicians, social workers, pilots, parents, baristas, whatever, doctors and lawyers even. You're already using the experience and skills that you gained here at Mount Allison. We hope you will remain connected to the university. You all got a little card from us that is going to tell you how to keep in touch with the alumni organization. There are lots of ways to remain engaged that don't necessarily have you putting your hand in your pocket. Lots of ways to provide support to others. Stay in touch with the alumni office and come back for reunions. Apparently the 20 and 21s are going to be great. Volunteer for local events wherever you're living, meeting other grads, offer a hand. Help someone new to town find a hockey league or a dentist or a great coffee shop. Connect to somebody in the same kind of work as you, or maybe even make a new friend with some common experiences. Keep the connections to the friends and the community at Mount Allison strong, and we're looking forward to seeing your future successes. Congratulations, everybody.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. Bienvenue. Class of 2020 and 2021, you're finally here. Your journey to this moment has taken a little longer than expected, but we're just so glad to at last have the chance to celebrate your achievements together. Il me fait très plaisir d'être ici avec vous aujourd'hui. Et je vous félicite d'avoir réussi cette étape importante de votre vie. Congratulations, graduates. You are unique in the university's history. You are the only two classes in more than 180 years to graduate in absentia. Comme on l'a souvent souligné pendant la pandémie, vous avez joué un rôle spécial dans l'histoire de notre institution. You'll be known for the contributions you make in your communities, for the advances you make in science and technology, for the creativity you bring to the world through your music and your art, for the work you do well and with enthusiasm, and for the kind words you share. Our honorary degree recipients today exemplify this. Dominique, vous avez concentré plus de 20 ans en service public et avez joué un rôle clé dans le gouvernement actuel. You've provided leadership during a very challenging period for our country. Je sens que vous êtes membre de la famille Mount Allison depuis longtemps, mais je suis heureuse de vous accueillir officiellement. Beth, we honor you today for your accomplishments as an author and photographer, and for the time you've dedicated to your community. Margaret, you are a part of the fabric of Mount Allison. You have supported so many students, first as a librarian, then in your three decades as chair of the Craig Foundation. And Scott, we're very proud to call you an alumni. Your success in business is exceptional, and your commitment to community service, volunteerism, and philanthropy sets you apart. It is a privilege to recognize you all with honorary degrees today. C'est un privilège de vous accorder ces doctorats honorifiques aujourd'hui. Presiding over Convocation Day is one of my favorite responsibilities as Chancellor of Mount Allison. Chaque année, j'attends avec impatience la cérémonie de remise des diplômes. What makes this celebration special is the opportunity it affords us to gather together and reflect on your efforts and accomplishments. Parents, I'd like you to know how much the entire university community enjoyed getting to know your graduate and watching their talents and their abilities develop and grow. Le soutien et l'encouragement que vous avez leur avez offert pendant les études sont appréciés. Congratulations on this important milestone in your family. Graduates, today we recognize your achievements and we celebrate a new chapter for each of you. You'll always remember your time at Mount Allison. You'll remember it for the things you learned, not just in class, but about yourself and the world. You'll remember it for the fun you had and the places you visited. But most especially, though, you will remember it for the people, the friends you've made, and those who have helped you along your way. It may be a favorite faculty member who took the time to cultivate your appreciation and understanding of their discipline. It may be a staff member who went the extra mile to help you when you needed it, or a member of the Sackville community who welcomed you in and made you feel at home. All of these people have been part of your life at a pivotal time. They are part of your story as you are part of theirs. Vous êtes pour toujours chez vous ici, à Mount Allison. So in closing, graduates, you each will get to write a different story, but as you do, I hope you'll keep a few things in mind. First, commit yourself to using your talents to their fullest. Second, commit yourself to a job well done. A job well done with your family, your career, and your friends. Third, commit yourself to being a positive force in the world. Congratulations, class of 2020 and 2021. Merci beaucoup. Félicitations.
I know, it's hot. Can't wait to get out of this and get into my running gear. To all of our speakers, thank you so very much, Madame Chancelier, Christy, Angelica, Nigel, Dr. Dominique Leblanc. Really appreciate your thoughts, your kind words, your wisdom, what you've brought to our Mount Allison community today and for years to come. As I'm sure you can appreciate, there have been many, many people who were involved in organizing this unique event at Mount Allison. The first time, of course, we brought two classes together in this manner. So this is very unique. This is a historic day at Mount A. A lot of these people have been working quietly behind the scenes, behind the stage, literally and figuratively. I would like to take a moment to thank all of them for their hard work in planning and putting on this special convocation ceremony today. If you are here amongst the people who've been helping to plan, put this event together, if you're on stage, if you're in the auditorium, if you're standing, if you're at home watching, if you're somewhere, I'd like you to stand right now, and please, we're going to applaud you for the great effort you've put on for bringing this convocation to life today. Please. Thank you. Some of them are already standing, of course, because they're helping to lead you in and out as part of our ushers and our marshals team. I would also like to extend a very special thank you to our professors, our instructors, our lab technicians, and everyone who teaches and supports classes and students at Mount A. The past 2 years, as we know, have been like no other, and many of our faculty and technicians and instructors have had to adapt, modify, change their curriculum with sometimes little more than a moment's notice. Thank you for your flexibility, your adaptability, and for going above and beyond to ensure that our students had the very best possible experience at Mount Allison. Again, if you're here on stage, in the auditorium, at home, watching through live streaming, please stand, and I'd like to lead a round of applause for you. Thank you. Yes, stand. Thank you so much. And to echo the comments of our provosts, it would not be possible without them here today. To our staff, many staff who work in many different diverse areas of this institution, from student services to facilities to housing to dining, thank you for not only keeping the doors open, but for keeping them open safely, especially over these past 2 years. You have all risen, rose to the many, many challenges so very beautifully. Again, if you're here, I ask you to stand. If you're watching at home, I ask you to stand. We really appreciate all of your efforts for this institution. This is an institution that relies on the very hard, dedicated work of all of our staff, and it's the little engine that could, and it's the institution that punches well above its weight. To our staff, thank you. And I would ask for one last round of applause to the classes of 2020-21. Thank you so much for coming back. We're so very proud of you all. Merci à toutes et à tous. On est très, très fiers. We're so very proud to call you all Allisonians, and we look forward to welcoming you back to campus to share your story, your narrative, for years to come. That officially concludes our formal ceremony. I want to thank you so much for being here today to celebrate our graduates.
We're going to close today with the famous, beautiful, amazing Alma Mater song, which can be found on page 2 of your program. You are asked to stand during the singing of the second chorus, and we know you know the words incredibly well. You've been rehearsing them all night, I know. You're asked to stand for the second chorus. This will be followed by O Canada and the recessional. Please remain in your seats until the procession has left the convocation hall.
Je prononce la cérémonie de remise du diplôme finie. I declare convocation closed. Un gros merci à toutes et à tous. Bon après-midi. On se parle à la prochaine. Merci.
And now it's time to leave this great convocation hall and go back to your homes and communities and into this world. Leave this place as proud alumni and take with you the memories of this place, the experiences that enriched you, and all the goodness that Mount Allison embodies. And then go home to your homes and communities. Take those values you've learned and spread them with diligence and joy. Go out and be community builders, work for justice and inclusion, and together let's create a world of peace. Let's go make a difference. Let's go and let's do it.